Okay, so what if we all just stopped using the most common cliches in images? What would be the new ones? What would be the new cliches that would be created? Hey guys, what is up? My name is Steven, and in today's video, we're gonna see the most common cliches that we tend to use in renderings and in illustrations, and why you should avoid them. And I wanna thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. The first 1,000 people to click the link in the description will get a free trial of premium membership so you can explore your creativity. So let's start with the oldest, most common cliche, which is using human cutouts that everyone is using, like the girl in the red dress. So put a finger down if you have used the girl with the red bag. Now put a finger down if you have used the little girl pointing at the horizon, and put a finger down if you have used the boy looking at the horizon with the red hat. If you have used three of these, then your images probably can be a little bit cliche or common. The easiest way to avoid this is to just get new cutouts and try to avoid or even delete your old cutouts. So I would recommend to check out this video right here, where I give you free, completely for free websites where you can get cutouts that are high quality and that don't have any price tag on them. But there are a ton of websites online that you can download human cutouts, and just go to your folder and delete all of that cliche human cutouts. Just delete them. That will avoid a lot of temptation to use them in your renderings. Now our second most common cliche is using a flock of birds around so they can ambient the air, feel free, so you can feel like you have a lot of nature around. And sometimes it just gets too noisy, it gets too tiring to see 10 birds, 20 birds flying in any type of building, in any type of context. So I mean, if you went outside and took a picture of your window, how many birds would you actually see? I mean, you may see one flying alone or two, but 10 every time is kind of hard. So we have to be a little bit more realistic that we don't always see that many birds flying around. And if we do, it's in a specific context. It doesn't mean that you can't use birds, but don't abuse them. Let the birds breathe a little bit. There should be like an association of digital birds that should limit the amount of birds that architects can use per rendering. So for example, can you even use like one flock of birds per year in your renderings? Or if not, then you will get fined as an architect. I don't know, I have no idea. I don't know what I'm saying. Save the digital birds, literally. Yeah, stop using so many birds. You can use other things instead, other things that can ambient the air, or sometimes white space is the best. But birds, I don't know, maybe use one bird, but not a flock of birds, right? So this bird, perfect. This third cliche is relatively new, but each day just gets much more intense. I go into Instagram and everyone is using it. And this is the digital collage sun. This is like the circle that everyone uses in the pictures, like right here, let's say. They think it goes well with all the images. We use yellow circles, yellow suns, red suns, sometimes even purple, you know, whatever color you can find. And of course, it looks nice. It creates a balance between the building and the actual sun, the actual environment, the whole composition. I understand, it looks nice. It's difficult to not use it because it is a big temptation and because we know that it's gonna look good. But we have to stop using it because it doesn't look as well as we can imagine. And it, now it looks like one of those techniques that anyone can use just to improve a normal rendering, and we lose sight of the quality of the building, of what you're actually trying to compose, trying to say in the actual frame of the composition of the illustration. So stop using the digital sun. You can maybe use other things in the sky that can complement it. Like for example, different types of clouds, like you know, these landscape artists in the 1800s that really painted with no sun, just with a lot of clouds around. And it just made for a great, great environment. I think Mir uses a lot of this technique. You know, or you can just also just leave it alone. Just don't put a sun, don't put anything. Even if it's a digital collage, we don't need sun. Okay, so this fourth cliche is probably the one that is the hardest to get rid of because it just makes everything look so much better. And this is using trees to beautify your images. If your building is ugly, then put some trees on it.
Okay.
If your plaza is ugly, put some trees on it.
Okay.
If your roof is ugly, put some trees on it. And sometimes it gets very tiring because people don't actually think of trees as something that they're actually gonna design and put into the design, but just something that beautifies the render. Sometimes something that makes it pretty, and that is it. But they don't actually think about, you know, the depth of the roots of the tree, of what types of trees can grow in that area, what types of trees are necessary for that building or its surroundings, whatever. But they just put trees because it looks beautiful. So we have to stop doing that. I commit that sin to every day as well, and it's very difficult to get rid of because trees just make everything else look pretty. Like, for example, here, without this fake tree right here, this other fake tree over here, and this ivy that is not fake, it's very real. You know, everything would look just a little bit more plain and it doesn't look as good. So I know that trees can beautify a lot of things, but you can replace it with another type of vegetation that can be equally as interesting. So for example, if you're in a desert context, you don't necessarily need trees. You can also look for vegetation that doesn't necessarily have a lot of green around it, or maybe that is another color, or, you know, just to try to find different vegetation that can adapt to the context of your building. So it just doesn't look as generic as, you know, these green trees that are everywhere and everyone is using them, you know, from China to Colombia to the United States, you know, wherever. And in our fifth cliche, we have overused artistic sculptures. Now, this is hard because when we're designing a museum, a cultural space, a school or whatever, we tend to use sculptures that are very well known, that are very famous, but that are outside of the limits of what that museum would actually get, or maybe outside of the budget. So for example, you would normally put an Alexander Calder sculpture into one of your renderings, or a Jeff Koons dog into one of your renderings, or this spider that was in the Guggenheim Museum into one of your renderings. And we have to be realistic. I mean, sometimes, you know, not the same sculpture is meant for every type of space in our renderings. And it would be nice to kind of pay a tribute or respect our local artists or our contextual artists and try to find out about them, you know, what other art is being done in our context and how we can support them through our renderings. So I think there should be another hashtag in this video, which would be hashtag support sculptures through renderings. Hello. Is it me, in our sixth cliche, we have one of the most overused cliches here, like in the rendering illustration world, which is the overuse of fog, ambient fog, rays, sun streaks, you know, all this environment that you normally put on top of an image to ambient it and to make it look much more, I don't know, maybe realistic, but it just ends up looking very dystopian. All those things can get a little bit tiring as well. So try to look at other render artists, try to look at other photographers of architecture and how they portray their building, the building that is in like the subject of a building. Not everyone uses all these effects. And I want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people. Explore new skills, deepen existing passions, and get lost in creativity. You can learn literally anything in Skillshare, from illustration, graphic design, animation, all over to productivity hacks and photography. It's curated specifically for learning, meaning there are no ads and they're always launching new premium classes, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And it's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. So one class that I really suggest you guys take is Daniel Scott's Adobe Illustrator Essentials Training. So for those of you that want to learn Illustrator but have no idea where to start, this is the perfect class for you. It has everything that a beginner needs just to be the best in Illustrator that you can be. So I really suggest you take a look at Daniel Scott's Essentials Training Illustrator class. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of premium membership so you can explore your creativity. You know, let's try to stop using these cliches. Obviously they look good, obviously they look interesting, and it's hard, that's why they're cliches, but we can do better. Let's try to adapt new ones. Which one do you think are the new common cliches that can, you know, be in trends in the next 10 or 5 to 10 years in rendering? Obviously, comment down below. And if you made it to the end of this video, please like and subscribe. It really helps me a ton. It really helps me knowing if you want to see more of these videos or if you like the channel. And yeah, that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you Skillshare for sponsoring this video. And I want to thank my Patreons also for sponsoring this video. So thank you, and I will see you in a next video. Bye. So I tried to avoid the cliche black shirt today just because I was talking about cliches, but I think I still have a lot of cliche things for architects. For example, these fake plants, I think are very architectural. I think my tattoos also are very architect cliche type of stuff. Maybe some books, maybe if you have a Rem Cool has books, you're probably a cliche as well. So sometimes we can't avoid being cliches. All right, so we have to stop. That's it. We can't use her anymore. It's been enough. It's been a long time. It's been some years, and we have to put her to rest. And I am talking about the girl in the red bag. We've had enough of her. That's it. We can't use her. Banned. We have to put her in a nursing home or something. I think that girl in the red bag must be about, you know, like very old right now, like 60, 70 years. So let's just stop using her. Let's just stop using her. Don't use her. I don't know what else to say about that girl. We have to stop using the girl in the red bag. I'm sorry. I know you like her a lot. She is cool. She has been to a lot of renderings. She, you know, tries to blend in with everybody, with the whole environment. But we can't keep inviting her. She always wears the same thing. She's always doing the same thing. She never looks at us. She's always looking, you know, towards another direction. You have to stop using her. That's it. You have to stop using the girl in the red dress. How many takes can I make on the girl in the red dress? I don't know.